Welcome to FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Secret of Hidden Atlantis. Chapter 1. Echoes of Atlantis. The year was 1952. A time when the world stood at the crossroads of exploration and mystery, and Michael Reynolds, an intrepid adventurer with a passion for uncovering the hidden truths of the world, found himself on the precipice of an extraordinary journey. His fascination with the enigmatic Atlantis, the legendary lost city whispered about in tales and myths, had grown into an obsession that ignited the flames of his adventurous spirit. Michael's quest for Atlantis began long before he set sail on the Voyager, his trusty vessel that had weathered storms and explored uncharted waters. It was a journey born from childhood stories, passed down by his grandfather, who spoke of a magnificent city submerged beneath the waves, a city that held the key to ancient wisdom and untold treasures. Those childhood tales had sparked a flame within Michael, a flame that now burned brightly as he prepared to unravel the mysteries of the deep. As the Voyager left the bustling harbor behind, Michael's excitement mingled with a sense of trepidation. The salty breeze carried with it the promise of adventure, but also the weight of the unknown. The vast expanse of the ocean stretched before him, a canvas of possibilities and perils, and the rhythmic creaking of the ship became a melodic backdrop to the anticipation that pulsed through his veins. The adventurer, clad in a weather-beaten hat and a jacket adorned with patches from previous expeditions, stood at the helm, his eyes fixed on the horizon where the sky met the sea. The sun dipped low, casting hues of orange and pink across the water, as if nature itself were conspiring to paint the backdrop for Michael's grand quest. The first chapter of his journey unfolded with the setting sun, casting long shadows on the deck of the Voyager. The crew, a diverse assembly of sailors and scholars, moved with purpose, their faces etched with a combination of excitement and respect for the quest they were about to embark upon. Michael's charismatic presence and unwavering determination had gathered this eclectic group, each member bringing their unique skills and knowledge to contribute to the expedition. The adventurer retreated to his cabin, where maps and ancient texts adorned the walls. The faded parchment maps, handed down through generations, were the artifacts of his familial connection to the tales of Atlantis. The hours melted away as Michael immersed himself in the details, tracing the routes of previous explorers who had dared to seek the submerged city. Each mark on the maps was a testament to the persistence of those who had come before him and an inspiration for the challenges that lay ahead. As night descended upon the Voyager, Michael stood on the deck, gazing at the celestial tapestry above. The stars, like ancient navigational beacons, guided his thoughts toward the mysterious depths that held the secrets of Atlantis. The moon cast a silvery glow on the undulating waves, and the adventurer felt a profound connection to the explorers of old, who had set forth into the unknown with nothing but the stars to guide them. The rhythmic sounds of the ship cutting through the ocean lulled Michael into a restless sleep. Dreams of underwater palaces and forgotten civilizations danced through his mind, visions that fueled his determination to push forward into uncharted territory. The first night of the expedition became a bridge between the known and the unknown, a liminal space where reality and myth converged. As dawn painted the sky in hues of pink and gold, Michael emerged from his cabin, renewed and resolute. The first light of day illuminated the expanse of ocean, stretching endlessly in every direction. The Voyager sailed toward the sunrise, a symbolic gesture that marked the beginning of Michael's quest to unveil the mysteries that lay beneath the waves. The chapters of his adventure were yet to be written, but as the Voyager sailed on, guided by the echoes of Atlantis, Michael Reynolds stood at the helm, ready to embrace the challenges, revelations, and wonders that awaited him in the pursuit of the legendary lost city. The sun rose higher, casting its golden glow on the intrepid crew and their vessel as they ventured further into the uncharted waters, chasing the echoes of Atlantis that reverberated through the pages of history. Chapter 2. Clues in the Deep. As the Voyager sailed deeper into uncharted waters, Michael Reynolds and his eclectic crew found themselves navigating through a labyrinth of mysterious isles and forgotten archipelagos. The maps, worn and weathered, guided them with a promise of hidden clues that could unravel the age-old mysteries of Atlantis. The salty air crackled with an air of anticipation, and the crew worked tirelessly, fueled by a shared passion for discovery. The first leg of their journey led them to an archipelago known to few, a cluster of islands that seemed to emerge from the sea like ancient sentinels guarding the secrets beneath. As the Voyager anchored in the sheltered cove, Michael donned his adventurer's gear, the sun glinting off the lenses of his weathered goggles. With a map in hand and the crew behind him, he set foot on land, guided by a sense of purpose and the echoes of Atlantis that resonated in the sea breeze. The islands held more than just picturesque landscapes. They harbored secrets buried beneath layers of time. Michael, accompanied by scholars versed in ancient languages and seasoned sailors adept at deciphering maritime codes, explored the islands, each step revealing fragments of a puzzle that had eluded explorers for centuries. Their journey led them to underwater caves where the remnants of an advanced civilization lay concealed beneath a tapestry of coral and marine life. The ancient artifacts, adorned with symbols that seemed to speak a language of their own, captured Michael's attention. The crew, armed with underwater torches, unveiled inscriptions etched into the very walls of the caves, a testament to a civilization that had thrived in harmony with the ocean's depths. As the adventurer deciphered the symbols, a narrative began to unfold. It wasn't just about Atlantis as a city, it was about a society that possessed knowledge far beyond its time. The clues in the deep hinted at people who had mastered the arts and sciences, living in symbiosis with the natural forces that surrounded them. Michael realized that Atlantis wasn't merely a city lost to the waves, it was a repository of wisdom that could potentially reshape the understanding of human history. The crew, their faces illuminated by the soft glow of underwater lanterns, gathered around Michael as he unveiled a series of scrolls recovered from the caves. The inscriptions spoke of an advanced civilization that had harnessed the energy of the ocean, an Atlantean society that revered the sea not just as a barrier but as a source of boundless knowledge and power. Guided by these newfound revelations, Michael and his crew ventured to other islands within the archipelago, each holding a piece of the puzzle. Ancient structures, half buried in the sand, whispered tales of a society that had once thrived on innovation and cultural exchange. The maps, now filled with annotations and sketches, became a testament to the collaborative effort that fueled the expedition. Michael's bond with Atlantis grew stronger as they investigated the hints further, going beyond the attraction of wealth and celebrity. The mystery developed into an introspective voyage, an attempt to comprehend a society that had impacted the ocean's surface on a fundamental level. Realizing the significance of their findings, the crew toiled with newfound zeal, motivated by a common desire to solve the mysteries of the deep. The chapters of their exploration unfolded across islands adorned with ancient ruins, where each step resonated with the echoes of an advanced society lost to time. The underwater caves, once silent witnesses to the eons that had passed, now echoed with the voices of scholars translating the inscriptions and sailors sharing tales of maritime exploits. The sun was setting and the ocean was glowing warmly as Michael and his crew headed to the next location on their map. As the Voyager proceeded on its mission, the moon rose higher in the night sky, illuminating the waves and the vessel's profile. Michael Reynolds, at the helm, felt a strong connection to the ancient civilization that pulled him from the depths. The clues unearthed in the deep had become threads in a tapestry that knitted together the story of Atlantis. The second chapter of their odyssey was marked not only by the physical discoveries, but by the intellectual and emotional connections formed between the crew and the enigmatic Atlantis. Each island, each underwater cave, held not only clues to the lost city's location, but also fragments of a cultural mosaic that fascinated and captivated those who sought to understand it. As the Voyager sailed on, guided by the maps and the clues in the deep, Michael Reynolds and his crew remained steadfast in their pursuit of Atlantis, ready to unravel the next layer of its mysteries that awaited them beneath the waves. The journey had become more than a quest for a mythical city. It was a pilgrimage into the heart of human history, where every discovery brought them closer to the truth hidden in the ocean's embrace. Chapter 3. Ancestral Forces Unleashed. The journey of Michael Reynolds and his diverse crew continued, fueled by the revelations uncovered during their exploration of the mysterious archipelago. As the Voyager sailed through uncharted waters, the chapters of their adventure unfolded against the canvas of a vast and ever-changing sea. The salty air carried with it a sense of anticipation, and the horizon beckoned them toward the next stage of their quest. Their course led them to the heart of an expansive ocean, where the waves seemed to hold the rhythmic pulse of a forgotten time. Michael, standing at the helm, traced the maps with his fingertips, guiding the ship toward coordinates that hinted at the proximity of Atlantis. The crew, now a tightly knit community bound by a shared purpose, prepared for the challenges that awaited them in the uncharted depths. As the Voyager sailed into unexplored territories, the waters beneath mirrored the uncertainty that lay ahead. The crew, with Michael at the forefront, faced not only the physical challenges of the journey, but also the metaphysical mysteries that surrounded the lost city. The enigma of Atlantis went beyond architectural marvels and ancient texts. It extended to the dormant forces that once safeguarded the city from external threats. The crew engaged in discussions, poring over the scrolls and artifacts recovered from the archipelago, seeking clues about the nature of the ancestral forces that had once protected Atlantis. Michael, now more than an adventurer, had become a custodian of knowledge, entrusted with the responsibility of understanding and, if necessary, preventing the resurgence of forces that held the potential to reshape the very fabric of their world. The third chapter of their odyssey unfolded as the Voyager sailed into an area marked by a magnetic anomaly, an indication of something extraordinary lying beneath. Michael, surrounded by scholars, navigators, and sailors, consulted the ancient texts that hinted at the presence of a dormant power linked to the fate of Atlantis. Their destination revealed itself in the form of a vast underwater trench, a chasm that seemed to plunge into the very heart of the Earth. The crew, armed with submersibles and diving equipment, prepared to descend into the abyss, where the secrets of Atlantis and its protective forces awaited. As the first submersible descended into the darkened depths, the crew marveled at the phosphorescent creatures that illuminated the way. The ocean floor, adorned with coral formations and ancient relics, seemed to hold its breath, as if guarding the secrets that lay hidden for centuries. The submersibles moved cautiously, their searchlights cutting through the darkness, revealing glimpses of a submerged world frozen in time. The crew, communicating through a network of underwater radios, shared their observations as they ventured deeper into the trench. It was during this descent that they stumbled upon an underwater chamber, a colossal cavern adorned with Atlantean symbols and intricate carvings that seemed to pulse with an otherworldly energy. Michael, leading the expedition from the primary submersible, felt a shiver run down his spine as the crew documented the chamber's contents. The walls, adorned with depictions of guardians wielding powers beyond human comprehension, hinted at the forces that had once protected Atlantis. The scholars, immersed in the translations, uncovered inscriptions describing a sacred pact between the inhabitants of Atlantis and the ancestral forces that served as custodians of their civilization. The crew, now deep within the trench, realized that they were not merely observers but participants in a journey that transcended the realms of history and mythology. The chapters of Atlantis's secrets merged with the exploration of the ancestral forces, intertwining the fate of the lost city with the very forces that had shaped its destiny. As the submersibles delved further into the cavern, they discovered an ancient artifact, a crystal pulsating with an ethereal glow. The scholars identified it as the Heartstone, a relic that had once served as the conduit between the Atlanteans and the ancestral forces. Michael, with a mixture of reverence and caution, held the artifact in his hands, feeling the energy coursing through him. The crew, now gathered around the Heartstone, became acutely aware of the responsibility they bore. The dormant forces that had protected Atlantis still lingered, and the expedition had unwittingly ventured into the epicenter of their potential resurgence. The chapters of their exploration took an unexpected turn as Michael grappled with the realization that the very forces they sought to understand were on the brink of awakening. The crew, facing the enormity of their discovery, engaged in heated discussions about the ethical implications of their continued pursuit. The scholars, while driven by academic curiosity, began to question the consequences of meddling with forces that had remained dormant for centuries. Michael, torn between the pursuit of knowledge and the responsibility he felt toward the world, navigated the complex waters of morality and destiny. The Heartstone, now a focal point of their deliberations, emanated an energy that seemed to respond to the discussions. The crew, sensing the weight of their choices, grappled with the decision to either continue their quest for Atlantis or take measures to prevent the resurgence of the ancestral forces. The third chapter of their odyssey concluded with the Voyager surfacing from the depths, the crew standing on the deck, their faces reflecting a mixture of awe and apprehension. The maps, once guiding them toward the lost city, now bore annotations that marked the intersection of knowledge and responsibility. As the ship sailed on, the crew carried with them not only the artifacts and scrolls, but the awareness that the chapters ahead would demand decisions that transcended the boundaries of discovery and delved into the realms of destiny and consequence. The echoes of Atlantis reverberated through the ship, a reminder that the quest for knowledge could unleash forces that held the power to shape the course of their world. Chapter 4. The Unveiling Tides. The crew of the Voyager sailed on, navigating the open sea with a palpable tension that hung in the air. The revelation of the Heartstone and the potential reawakening of ancestral forces had cast a shadow over their once enthusiastic pursuit of Atlantis. Michael Reynolds, burdened by the weight of responsibility, spent long hours on the deck, gazing into the horizon as if seeking answers from the undulating waves. The maps, now annotated with the coordinates of the underwater trench and the chamber housing the Heartstone, became a tangible representation of the crossroads at which the crew found themselves. Scholarly debates and philosophical discussions echoed through the ship, each member grappling with the implications of their discoveries. The chapters of their journey had evolved from a straightforward quest for a lost city to a complex moral dilemma that tested the very fabric of their humanity. Amidst the contemplative atmosphere, the Voyager sailed toward the next destination marked on the maps, a series of ancient isles rumored to hold the final clues leading to Atlantis. The crew, though consumed by uncertainty, rallied around Michael, who remained determined to see the quest through, but now with a newfound awareness of the consequences that could unfold. As the ship approached the islands, the crew disembarked with a mix of trepidation and resolve. The landscape, dotted with remnants of an ancient civilization, seemed to echo the whispers of a time long past. The explorers, once driven solely by the thrill of discovery, now approached each artifact and inscription with caution, aware of the delicate balance between unraveling history and disturbing the forces that lay dormant. The islands contained hints that linked the Atlanteans, the ancient energies, and the possible repercussions of interfering with nature's order. Leading the mission, Michael aimed to comprehend the old customs and ceremonies that had once preserved the balance between the forces of the otherworld and the human world. The scholars, armed with translations and historical context, pieced together the narrative etched into the ruins. The Atlanteans, in their pursuit of knowledge and power, had forged a pact with the ancestral forces, a pact that ensured the protection of their civilization but came with a solemn agreement to remain dormant until a future generation deemed worthy. The crew, absorbing this revelation, grappled with the realization that their very quest had disrupted the delicate balance that had endured for centuries. The maps, once guiding them with a sense of purpose, now felt like scrolls of destiny, their unfurling pages leading toward an uncertain future. As the crew explored the final island in the archipelago, Michael uncovered a chamber adorned with murals depicting the symbiotic relationship between the Atlanteans and the ancestral forces. The murals illustrated ceremonies conducted by the Atlantean priesthood to commune with these forces, ensuring a harmonious coexistence. The Heartstone, now a relic of profound significance, resonated with the energies of the island. Michael, guided by a sense of duty, approached the artifact with a mixture of reverence and apprehension. The crew watched, their faces illuminated by the soft glow emanating from the Heartstone, as Michael performed a ritual learned from the ancient inscriptions. As he concluded the ritual, the chamber seemed to respond with a subtle vibration. The crew, attuned to the energy surrounding them, felt a shift in the air. The ancestral forces, once stirred by the crew's unintentional interference, began to recede into the depths, returning to their dormant state. The chapters of their odyssey reached a critical juncture as Michael, now more than an adventurer, emerged from the chamber. The maps, once symbols of uncharted territories, had become a record of choices made and the consequences faced. The crew, their expressions a mix of relief and introspection, gathered around Michael, acknowledging the gravity of their journey. As the Voyager set sail from the ancient isles, the crew carried with them not only the artifacts and scrolls, but the wisdom gained from the unraveling chapters. The quest for Atlantis had transformed from a pursuit of the tangible to a journey into the intangible, the realms of ethics, responsibility, and the delicate balance between knowledge and humility. As the Voyager sailed into the fading light, the crew, their camaraderie strengthened by shared trials, looked toward the horizon with a renewed sense of purpose. The echoes of Atlantis, once tumultuous, now reverberated as whispers carried by the wind, a testament to the resilience of the human spirit in the face of the unknown. The voyage continued, propelled by the lessons learned, and the crew, now custodians of both knowledge and humility, embraced the unfolding chapters with a sense of reverence for the enigmatic forces that shaped their destinies.